Did you know that Kittl has its own AI feature? In this video, I'm gonna do a full tutorial on the new AI feature in Kittl. I'm gonna show you where to find it, how it works, the limitations, everything. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna talk about the new AI feature in Kittl. They've done a little bit different than Midjourney and some of the other text-to-image things like Canva. I'm gonna break down the ways that they're different and how they kind of solve the problem of getting different kinds of things, pictures and images on their site. I think it's a really creative way to do it. I'm gonna show you how to use it as well as the background remover, because we know sometimes there's a background on there and this, so they solve that as well to take out the background so that you can use it on t-shirts and other print-on-demand products. So let's get into Kittl right now. Lots to show you. I'm gonna show you exactly where to find it and kind of everything there is to know about the AI feature on Kittl. All right, so here we are on Kittl, kittl.com. You can see right there, kittl.com. The first thing you're gonna see is this, Kittl AI is coming, join the wait list. So I already have Kittl AI, you may have it or you may not. If you don't have it, click on here and you can see all the things that are coming. So you may not have the same things I do, but we can click on here. Let me show you what happens when you click on here. So you can see here, it opens a separate tab and you can get early access, put your email in here and they'll send the early access to you, I believe. And you can see all the different types of AI stuff that it can do, pretty powerful. We're gonna go over it, but here's all the people who have tried it. Everybody says five stars. You can generate logos, you can generate designs for t-shirts and remove backgrounds. I'm gonna show you all of this today. And then this just goes over all the different things. And I'm gonna show you another place on there where we can look more into these. So let's get out of here. I'm gonna close this tab and we're gonna just start a new project. So I'm gonna hit start new project and I'm gonna make mine 4,500 by 5,400, like I'm doing a t-shirt design here and that orientation. And remember, if you've seen my videos, you know you don't have to change this DPI unless you're doing it by inches. And we're gonna hit that. And AI, if you do have it, is down here. So underneath all these, the last one here is Kittl AI. So I'm gonna click on here and you can see very easy. You're gonna start off with some credits depending on who you are. I was able to get Drew gave me some extra credits. So I have more than the 100 credits and this is so that I can show you how it works. And the credits are for generating each one of these. So each time you generate a new AI, it will take a credit. And so there's 100 credits. Unless you're gonna do more than 100 a month, I think you'll be fine. So I'm gonna show you how to do it. First thing I'm gonna do is click on this learn more. So we can kinda, it's gonna explain all these different image styles, clip art styles, vector styles. You can see it's divided into four separate groups: images, clip arts, vectors, and patterns. And we're gonna go over that by clicking learn more. So learn more opens up a new tab. So if you ever need any questions when you have this, you can always click on that. And you can see kind of like the other tab, but this one's just more detailed. It's gonna show you exactly what you need to do. Open the Kittl AI tool, write the prompt. Kind of if you're familiar with any other text to image, you know to write those prompts. And then what's different about Kittl than anything else is it has all these styles, and I'm gonna go over the different styles. I think Kittl has the most styles, at least visually. I think maybe some other ones you have to like know what to type in there for styles, but visually you can see what kind of styles you're gonna get for Kittl, and which I think is really great. And then it will generate your image. So first, image styles. So you can see this is how you do it. And of course you can read more. I'm gonna kind of go through it really quickly, but you can see they typed in this prompt and got this foggy scene. They typed in this prompt and got this. So these are the different image styles. You got digital art, photography, palette knife, just so many different ones, painting, abstract here, psychedelic, and so on. Even anime, which is really cool. So these, I would say, these are more like posters and paintings and pictures. You can still crop them, but I think these are made more for full bleed and things like that. So you can see here, photography, painting, sceneries, those kinds of things. If you're looking for that, these are the image styles you wanna do, and then you can kinda pick a different one. So next you have the clip art style. So these are the ones where they're kind of clipped out, or at least have a solid background that you can remove the background really easily. So these, again, prompts right here, just real easy, an avocado, and then they clicked on the kawaii icon. So you can see here, kawaii icon. The way they got this one is this is the product shot. So you come on here, product shot, and so on. So just showing you examples of what each one is, which I think is really cool. So you can still kind of refine it by the style of clip art that you want, which is really cool. They have 9 of these right here. And then of course they're talking about the AI background. So when you have one of these, usually has a white background, and then you can just click on it. I'll show you how to do that, super simple. And then the second to last one here, there's 4 of them. This is vector, so solid color, just one color. So icons, vector illustrations, silhouettes, those kinds of things you can see right here, pretty cool. And street art is more, it's kind of like a silhouette, but with a, like a paint spray. So that's pretty cool too. And really neat how they got all of these things. Line art, and these do really well for like stickers and t-shirts too. So really happy that they got this line art. Lastly is patterns. So of course, print on demand uses patterns for things like blankets and pillows and phone cases and totes and all of those. So you don't have to kind of make your own, it will do a pattern for you. So pretty cool here too. And it has different kinds of patterns. So you can do cute or textured or painted or whatever. And if you want a texture that's different than what they already have, Kittl already has all these graphics and textures and stuff. But if you want something new that somebody else doesn't have that's using Kittl, you can make your own textures, your own patterns, your own stuff. So frequently asked questions down here. If you have any questions, they probably have the answer to it right there. So I'm gonna close this. You can read this on your own time. If you have it, and if you don't have it, then you don't need to read it yet. Just wait till you get it and click on that link right here. So learn more. Okay, so let's try these out. Excited to show you what I'm doing here. So it's Easter. We're gonna do like a bunny rabbit. We'll try different ones. So I'm gonna do rabbit and we'll see how they work on these different ones. So I'm gonna do image style. Lots of good ones. I'm gonna try anime. Anime rabbit, let's see, go for it. So you can see it's gonna do it right here. And the difference between this and a lot of the other text to image ones is it's just gonna give one picture. So that's how the one credit works. It's not gonna give 4 different pictures and have you pick it like a lot of the other ones, like Midjourney and Canva. This one's only gonna give you the one picture and it will save it to you. Wow, look at that. So we got rabbits here in an anime style. I'm gonna zoom in here. That's pretty cool. I don't know why this head is floating here, but anime does that sometimes. So I'm not gonna use the AI background remover. I'm just gonna tell you where this goes. So now this is yours. You might have noticed it took a credit from my credits here. And if you ever need this, it will be in your uploads right here. So I'm gonna click on uploads. And you can see it was added here. Here are some other AI ones that I tried out earlier. And you can see you can always have access to it. So even if you don't decide to use it right away, you can use it later. It's yours now, you spent the credit to get it and so on. So let's go back to Kittl AI. I'm gonna try a different one. I'll take this out. We're gonna try rabbit, same thing. You can do more detailed here. You can do pink rabbit or funny rabbit, whatever you want, but I'm just gonna do rabbit just to keep it simple. So kawaii icon, let's see. Let's generate an image there and see what it comes up with. And again, one picture, one credit, you'll see it's 288. It should go down to 287. Yes, it did. And here's my kawaii rabbit, right? Pretty cute here. Now, let me show you, hopefully this works here. I'm gonna do my background, you know, right there. So you can see it has a white background. So if I do this AI background remover, let's see what happens. Boom. And there you go. So you can see it took out some of that white there, but that's okay. I can fill that in. So this is really good. So if you want to put it on like a circle or whatever, it will be in front of it, right? So now I don't have to worry about it. I can use this whatever, and I can scale this up. And it's pretty good. It's a kawaii rabbit. So one of the nice things about having this Kittl AI is it's generating designs that are not on Kittl, right? So if somebody is looking up designs and elements, and they do kawaii rabbit. They're not gonna find this because this was generated just for me, see? So that's one way to be original, stand out, have something different than everybody else. They're not gonna be able to have this. This is my own, and which is why it costs a credit. So let's try one more. I'm gonna delete that. And let's do rabbit, but with like a silhouette. So there you go. If you ever need silhouettes, you can see you can put in any animal, anything right here. You could put a palm tree or a car or whatever you want. I did a rabbit, so I can use this silhouette for Easter and anything that needs a rabbit. I could make a t-shirt design with this. And it looks really good. You can see when I scale it up, it's still pretty clean, right? It's not pixelating or anything. So that's good there. Okay, last one. Let's see patterns. So I'm gonna do patterns. I'm gonna pick one that's not in this top three. Maybe this one, flat and rabbit, and let's go. There you go, an original rabbit pattern here. So pretty cool. You can put these on your phone cases, on your tote bags and things like that, or just use it as a background for something else in the design. So pretty cool. So we went over all the different styles, we generated the images, we did the AI background remover. One thing that I wanted to show you is the different plans for this. So you can see I have 100 credits right there, and that's because I have the subscription plan. I'm gonna show you which one. So these subscription plan, I am on the expert plan, so I have 100 credits a month. And if you're on the pro plan, you get 20 credits per month. So that's the different things. That's what it is right now. And you can go try it out with 100 if you have the expert again and pro. We don't have Kittl AI for free. So if you have the free plan, you won't see any Kittl AI. It's just for the pro and expert right now. Yeah, so that's everything I think you need to know for Kittl AI. Go around and try it if you have it. If not, go sign up to get it on Kittl. It's pretty new, and I'm sure they're gonna get better and better and better. You can see already the thing that I really like about this, and I said this before, is all this different styles, and you can see visually what it is instead of having to kind of type a command about it. So if you want something that is a painting, just pick painting, right? If you want something that is kawaii, you can just click on kawaii and it knows right away without it having you to write it in the prompt here. So I think that's really cool. I look at things visually, and that really helps me. So that's Kittl's new AI feature. Let me know in the comments what you think about it. Try it out. If you've seen other people do it, let me know if you're gonna use it or what you would use it for. I think it can be really powerful, and I like all the different styles that it has. I'm gonna try and use it to make a t-shirt design in the future for it. I didn't wanna do it in this video just because there's so much to cover. If you haven't seen this Kittl video right here where I teach you how to do a vintage 70s design, you can watch that video. It's a great one to do a vintage 70s t-shirt design. I go over all the steps. Thanks again for watching, and as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.